We want to find out what's out there. We want to be able to, you know, expand our horizons. I think that that truly is built into the human spirit. We're always wondering, what's next? How much farther can we go?
The Mercury astronauts, when they get introduced, immediately coalesce as sort of the heroes. The press conference that NASA had goes crazy, and the astronauts become instant celebrities. They sort of look like knights in armor in some ways, going out there to defend the honor of the United States.
3, 2, 1, 0, liftoff. All right, lift off, and the clock has started.
I remember feeling a moment of exhilaration. Exhilaration because, of course, I'd been training for 2 years, and in fact, I was more than ready for the liftoff to occur, and was quite delighted that, in fact, it did occur, and occurred so smoothly.
Roger, 0G, and I feel fine. Capsule is turning around. Oh, that view is tremendous.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
It's outward bound. You know, people have a human feeling, I think, for wanting to go outward bound. It's in us, you know, to go, to see, to touch, to understand what's there.
Ignition sequence start.
We finally come to the day, the moment. The trajectory had been wrong. They were targeted into this inhospitable place. Then they had to fly over this area at a high forward velocity, then pitch up to slow down so that kill their forward velocity, and then start down like a helicopter.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
The landing to me was a great celebration. We had won the race. The nation was almost euphoric.
The knowledge that we gain about the origin and the evolution of the moon is one of these days going to help us right here on Earth. Of course, it's only one area, but I believe it's an important area, and I guess I'm betting a lot on it.
NASA has been absolutely critical to improving the knowledge of all humankind. 12 humans walked on the surface of the moon, which is a stunning achievement, and we are still the only country ever to have done that. We're going to go back to the moon, and we're going to take what we learned there, and we're going to go to Mars.
To get to Mars, it's about a 6-month journey. And as an operator, I would be really, really happy if we could test out our operations and our equipment in our backyard. The moon's only 3 days away. The moon is the next step.
So the space station, it's more than 1 million pounds. It's as big as 2 football fields. You are not going to bring that up in one single lift. So we had to bring up the space station in parts and assemble it. The space shuttle was instrumental to bringing up at least the American side of that. It was more than 40 missions over about 13 years to assemble all those parts of the space station.
And so human spaceflight is really interesting because we do adapt really quickly to the environment. How quickly it felt natural to float around. How quickly it felt normal to look out the window and see the Earth go by.
Human beings are built to be able to adapt to weightlessness, and that allows us to go do that exploration. And so we have improved the exercise equipment, we improved the diet, the vitamins. I mean, we came back so strong that physically, I was actually stronger than when I left, when I did the physical fitness tests when we got back. It gives me great hope that, you know, if we have similar type of equipment on our long duration space vehicles, we're gonna show up on Mars and be ready to work the minute we get there.
Orion, our state-of-the-art spacecraft, is designed to take crews into deep space, and then once their work is done, to safely bring them back home. Sometimes folks ask me, you know, what do you think the next 60 years has in store? I don't know all of the destinations that we will visit, the mysteries that we will solve, the places that we will leave footprints again.
And we want to see what's out there. We want to see how it works. We want to go explore, there's always this desire to learn more, to satisfy that inquisitive nature. Let's go do it.
Subscribe for more of NASA's 60th anniversary.